Like, you would expect it to flick out right here. Open up your arms, spread them wide. Nothing's gonna hold me back this time. I've been waiting for you all my life, counting down the minutes till tonight. So open up your heart at the end, let the love finally begin. 'Cause I've been waiting for you all my life, counting down the minutes till tonight. Open up your... What's going on, guys? Today we're in a 2014 Genesis 2.0. It's got some bolt-ons. It still has a stock turbo, so I'm curious to see how well a Genesis can perform with some simple upgrades. It's got suspension mods, intake, exhaust, and a couple other small little things, but I'm very curious to see how it's gonna do. I've heard a lot about these cars. I know there's a huge aftermarket platform for them, so I'm definitely interested to see how a 2.0 performs. I've been in a lot of 3.8s, so then that would be the seatbelt shine. My seatbelt is on. Passenger seatbelt on, and we're good. So the car is making around 320 torque and 280 wheel. It definitely feels it. I didn't expect it getting in the car, hearing it from the owner, but the torque is right on port. It definitely just shoves you right in your seat. There's a lot more turbo spool, faster than I expected. Brakes are stock, but they still feel bitey. It definitely shoves you back in your seat. It's not a slouch at all. So I guess we're gonna be filming the rest of this review in the rain. So hopefully the owner is gonna end up doing a transmission tune to the car. So the next time we drive it, it'll be nice and sunshine. But for now, we get to play around with the modified Genesis in the rain. I think that's still fun. This is the 8-speed automatic because it's a 2014 and they start changing it in 2013 to the automatics. And what I've heard is that they get really good gas mileage if you're in 8th gear just cruising around, and that's exactly what's happening right now. We're averaging above 25 miles per gallon, which is not bad. You just get straight turbo sounds coming out from the interior of the car. Right here near the dash, it literally just sounds like it's coming right at you. That's a very interesting sound. So is the 8-speed automatic Genesis worth it? Let's find out. Definitely got some pull. This is a fun one for sure. The owner's done a lot of tasteful mods to the car. In the interior, we have a gauge pillar with fuel, turbo, and oil pressure. He's kept it relatively stock in the interior for just a simple look, but the exterior has definitely had some modifications. We have wheels, suspension, a rear diffuser, a front splitter, some small canards in the front. It definitely gave it a much more aggressive appearance than it did stock. So what I'm noticing immediately is that in the newer Genesises from 2013 and up, the automatic transmissions are different than the 2011s and under. So the shifts are actually a lot faster, and it definitely feels faster. I wouldn't say as quite as fast as a Volkswagen transmission or an upgraded BMW transmission, but it's definitely good for what it is. And I'll be curious to see what the automatic transmission upgrade is gonna be like for this car, because I hear you have an automatic launch control. So that's gonna be awesome. So the car has a tile blow-off valve, and I'm sure you can just hear it on the inside here, right here. Just hear it spool. We're definitely in a spaceship. Do you hear that? All right, we're going to Mars. Hang on, boys. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, and go. This is a little fun car. It kind of reminds me of a little faster Miata, a little bit bigger of a body, but it's still got that
go fun kind of attitude. It's not crazy power where you're just playing it in your seat and you're holding on for dear life, but it's more of, this is a lot of fun. Let's go take a nice little cruise. I'll do a second gear pull real quick and go. It definitely goes. The sounds are very fun in this car. Definitely has a nice idle. It's a full custom exhaust. It's basically catless downpipes and custom after that. But we've got a bridge, so let's hear how that sounds. When you let off the gas, you get a lot of blow off valve. Just a lot of blow off valve sounds. I can definitely see why this car appeals to a large range of young car enthusiasts who want to get into their first sports car. It makes good power for the money. You can be just as quick as a 3.8, if not faster, with some bolt-ons. I know the owner has done some runs with a stock 3.8 and put about a car length on it. It's a really neat, fun car. I would definitely approve of this car for being a first car. The automatic transmission is better than I expected. It's not as slouchy as I was expecting, especially with the upgrades that it did from 2013 and above. I think it's a long way from what it was in 2011. So the car makes 21 PSI with the tune and 18 stock. Now you would think that's not that many pounds of boost higher, but it definitely feels a lot quicker. So the owner has kindly let me do a dig in this car. He still hasn't done a dig in this car with his new wheel setup, so I'm definitely curious to see how it's gonna do. All right, we're in Mexico. It moves, but I think we could do a harder launch than that. I think it gripped.
Yeah,
you liked it? He's like, oh my god, I've never felt this before. Woo!
How did your wheel set?
It's just straight slipping after 2000. Really good. Little skirting first, gets traction, it bites. Really curious to see how this car does with an upgraded turbo. I think this thing would move for sure. Definitely be an underdog. No complaints about the automatic transmission. It's, you know, still holding in, nothing's broken yet. I'm pushing it to its limit, so I'm not seeing any slippage really. It does have a little bit of a delay, but that's expected for a stock transmission. The upgraded transmission definitely will do a lot. We will have the update video for that. But as far as stock goes, this is not bad. I've driven way worse. Like you would expect it to flick out right here. Got a nice little slidey action going on here. It just wants to go all over. It just slips. Fighting for traction, and it's just sliding. Oh my god. This car definitely impressed me. The automatic transmission was not as sluggish as I was expecting. We're gonna have some update videos with the upgraded automatic transmission coming at you soon, and possibly an upgraded turbo. Until next time, if you want to check out more of the build, George_BK2 is the Instagram. He posts a bunch of photos, so you'll be able to keep updated with there. Thank you so much to the owner. I love this car. It was a lot better than I was expecting it to be. Hearing a lot of rumors and stories about 2.0s and 3.8s being sluggish, I think the weight of this car and the power it's putting out and how it puts it out is definitely really good for a beginner and a novice and even getting into serious some track builds. Like, I would love to see what a 2.0 or a 3.8 can perform on the track. But until next time, peace out, and I'll see you later. So with my luck, halfway through this review, it started pouring, aka Florida bipolar weather. But when it pours and you have a rear-wheel drive car, trash control's off, and... Moose! That doesn't get tiring. That's just straight fun. This car definitely impressed me. The automatic transmission was not as sluggish as I was expecting. We're gonna have some update videos with the upgraded automatic transmission coming at you soon, and possibly an upgraded turbo. Until next time, if you wanna check out more of the build, George_BK2 is the Instagram. He posts a bunch of photos, so you'll be able to keep updated with there. Thank you so much to the owner. I love this car. It was a lot better than I was expecting it to be. Hearing a lot of rumors and stories about 2.0s and 3.8s being sluggish, I think the weight of this car and the power it's putting out and how it puts it out is definitely really good for a beginner and a novice, and even getting into serious some track builds. Like, I would love to see what a 2.0 or a 3.8 could perform on the track. But until next time, peace out, and I'll see you later. So party, my man, there's just something about you, just me to a savage.